Hello, my dear children. How are all of you? I hope all of you are fine, taking care of yourself and taking care of your mama and papa also at home. My name is Shivanjali and I'm back with another story for you. So today's story is on the rainbow. On the rainbow. Have you ever seen a rainbow? Well, I'm sure all of you have seen a rainbow in the sky. Rainbow is very beautiful to look at. It is very soothing to the eyes. Yeah, it's colorful and pretty. So my dear children, do you know when does a rainbow appear in the sky? A rainbow appears in the sky when rain and sun are together in the sky. When it's raining also and the sun is also in the sky, then the rainbow appears. Yes. And do you know, my dear children, a rainbow is made up of 7 colors. It is made up of 7 colors. Yes. And a rainbow is also known as Wibgyor. It is known as Wibgyor. And Wibgyor stands for each of the names of the colors. So, do you want me to tell you the name of the colors? Well, let's start. Wibgyor. First is we. We, violet. Wibgyor, I, indigo. Wibgyor, B, blue. Wibgyor, G, green. Wibgyor, Y, yellow. Wibgyor, O, orange. Wibgyor, R, red. Wibgyor, yes. 7 colors. So now let's hear the story of the rainbow. Once upon a time, the colors of the world started fighting with each other. They were all fighting amongst themselves, quarreling, getting angry and arguing. And you know what the topic was? Why this started? Well, they all wanted to prove who is the greatest, who is the most powerful and who is the favorite. Yes, so they all started fighting with each other. Green, the color of nature, came into the picture. And green said, clearly, I am the most important. I am the sign of life and hope. I was chosen for grass, leaves and the color of the trees. Without me, all animals would also perish. Look out over to the countryside and you will see that I am in majority. I am the most. I am the most in color. So, I am obviously the most important. If I am in majority, then who came? Then the color blue came. Blue did not like this argument. Blue said, what? Blue said, I am the color of calmness. I am the color of calmness. You only think about the earth, but consider the sky and the sea. It is the water that is the basis of life and drawn up by the clouds from the deep sea. And we all know that earth is made up of mostly water, 70% of water. So that is why I am the most important. The sky gives space and peace and serenity. Without my peace, you would all be nothing. You would all be nothing. And then what happened? I don't think the color yellow liked it. The color yellow did not like it. So the color yellow stepped in. And yellow said, oh God, you all are getting so serious and you all are very serious colors also. So no wonder. I am the color of sunlight. I am the color of happiness. I bring laughter, gaiety and warmth to the world. The sun is yellow. The moon is yellow. The stars are yellow. And every time you look at a sunflower, the whole world starts to smile. without me, there would be no fun. There would be no fun. Then who came? The color orange. The color orange. Orange said, I am the color of healing. I am the color of healing. I am the color of health and strength. I may be scarce, but I am precious, for I serve the needs of human life. I carry the most important vitamins. Think of carrots, pumpkins, oranges and mangoes. And but when I am the color of pumpkins, oranges and mangoes. Don't hang around all the time, but when I fill the sky at sunrise or sunset, my beauty is so striking that no one gives another thought to any of you. No one else thinks about any of you after that, because I am there in the sky and everybody feels at peace. Now, the color red said, oh God, they all are going on and on and on. Let me tell them who I am. I am the color of life. I am the color of life. I said, Red said, I can't stand it any longer. So he started shouting. He said, I am the ruler of all of you. I am blood, life's blood. I am the color of danger and of bravery. I am willing to fight for a cause. I bring fire to the blood. I am the color of love. I am the color of the red rose. Without me, the earth would be as empty as the moon. As empty as the moon. Can you think about our earth without a moon? No. So same way Red said, if the earth cannot be without the moon, the same way any human that is on earth cannot be without blood. And what is the color of blood? Red. Yes. Then who came? Purple came into the picture. Purple said, I am the color of spirit. I am the color of spirit. Yes. I am the color of royalty and power. I am the color of royalty and power. Kings, chiefs and bishops have always chosen me, for I am a sign of authority and wisdom. People do not question me. They obey. My orders. Okay, so I am of lot of pomp, strength, and I am assertive in nature. Okay, then who came? Then Indigo came. Who came? Indigo. Indigo said, well, let me show all these colors who I am and what I am. I am the color of serenity. I am the color of serenity. And I am the color that is dealing with determination. I talk about determination. Think of me. I am the color of silence. I am the color of silence. You hardly notice me. But without me, you will all become superficial. You will all be superficial. I represent thought and reflection. Thought and reflection. Twilight and deep water. You need me for balance and contrast, for prayer and inner peace. So what did Indigo say? That you need me for balance and contrast, for prayer and inner peace. So then what happened? All these colors started continue fighting. They all presented their argument. And they all again continued fighting. I said, no, I'm big, I'm greater, I'm important, I'm the most powerful. And as their quarreling got louder and louder, they got so loud while quarreling, there was a flash of lightning. There was a flash of lightning in the sky. And what happened? The thunder came. And when the thunder came, the thunder growled. As the thunder was very angry with all these colors, the thunder said, "Are you all serious? You all are serious?" And then they all looked here and there. Whose voice was this? Whose voice was this? So the colors crouched down in fear, drawing close to one another for comfort. They came close to each other for comfort as they all got scared. And the thunder rolled and boomed to scare all of them. The thunder rolled and boomed to scare all of them. And then the rain began to speak. And as they could see the rain, all the colors could see the rain said, "You all are foolish colors, fighting amongst yourselves, each trying to dominate the rest. Don't you know you would each meet for a special purpose, unique and different? Join hands with one another and come to me." Doing as they were told, the colors united and joined hands. They stopped fighting, but the rain continued. And now, from now, what happens is when it rains, each of you will stretch across the sky in a great bow of colors as a reminder that you can all live in peace. The rainbow is a sign of hope for tomorrow. And so, whenever a good rain washes the world and a rainbow appears in the sky, let us remember to appreciate one another. Let us remember to appreciate one another. So the rainbow, thunder and lightning solved this problem and made the colors realize that each of you are giving different things to everyone in the world. You're all representing different things. That is for a reason. Those are unique qualities. And so you must fulfill your purpose and you should not quarrel. You should work with unity in providing happiness to everyone who looks at you. When you are in the sky, everyone will look at you and feel happy and calm and feel that you are that feel good and feel that yes, there is a better tomorrow, as you are a sign of hope for a better tomorrow. So children, that story was very good. Okay, no matter how the times are so tough right now, but remember, whenever you see a rainbow, you should always think that it is a sign of hope for a better tomorrow. Okay, things will get better. You should all hang in there, be with your family and stay at home. Take care of yourself and I'll see you soon with another story for you. Bye.